Okay, we're back. Again, I'm making sure that this and this and this go together, and that I want this to be on the front where these little ports for the exhaust go. So I am going to dive in here with a little glue. Geez, a little, I said. Crazy person. And I'm going to just put some glue on the edge all the way around. And the hope is that it sort of has formed its shape already. And then I can sort of grab this guy. Maybe use this. I can kind of grab this guy. And plop them on there. And give them a gentle tap. And sort of form it with my fingers a little bit. Make sure it's kind of at the right angles, correct angles. And if it's not perfect, it's not the end of the world. See, something's way out of whack. Give it a little push. Like that piece seems to be a little out of whack. And that piece there. But overall, not bad. Sometimes it helps to squeeze multiple edges like this. So squeeze top and bottom, and then squeeze from this side. And kind of just keep working your fingers around like that. And this glue does dry pretty fast. It's tacky quickly. And you will end up then with some dang close. Yeah, it isn't perfect, but not bad. Okay, so before we go any further, we may as well, a little push so it's kind of like it's flat, may as well stick this guy on here, what do you say? Because that is the next thing to go. And this again is supposed to be on that gray piece, and it should attach and be squashed down all the way around. Ideally, this is going to be in the center. And I think we'll be close. Maybe this needs to be pushed down a little bit to form it a little bit. So, let's well, actually, that's done. Let's put this side on, because that'll give it more body and strength. So let's put a little bit of this glue around the edges on the other side. And there, glue all the way around on the edge. And again, this glue is nice because it does dry clear. And that will help us. Absolutely. Start by lining it up as best you can on an edge. Give it a little pressure like that. Look, see? The edges now are actually in line. Obvious, son of a gun. So I was wrong the first time. I edge glued it on the wrong side, so this now fits pretty perfectly. So I was completely wrong. But now this is the front. And just so that I don't mess up, not that I ever would, I'm going to put front here so that I know for sure. So that means this and this go in here. So now let's see if we can get that little jobby on here. In reality, it's probably gonna squish kind of flat, but that's okay. Let's give it a little, maybe stick it on here. Hold it like that. Put a little glue around the outside edge. This is probably too much glue, but I'm not good enough at the paper models to rely on finesse at this point. I sort of give it the beans. Okay. Jeez, that turned out really well. Okay. If you're anal, you can try to get out some of this stuff with a little extra glue here and there. Like that. Good. Good. Since it's flat, we'll go stick this guy on. This one should go on relatively easily. Relatively easily. So I'm just going to put some glue on the outside edge. This little piece we can't get on there, that'll be alright. We can sort of fake that one. So let's see if she... to me that should probably line up somewhere too, depending on where the little, where does it go on the real airplane? Those are right in the middle of the cylinders. Okay, so I'm just going to put this so that those little black dots, these little black dots right here, boom boom, all the way around, are lined up approximately with a cylinder. So there's a cylinder and there's a black dot. Because I think those are going to be where 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Yeah, those are where. Oh, so you can see the edge. You can see what it looks like. It looks pretty cool. It's going to give the illusion of a solid heavy crankcase. Very nice. Very nice indeed. And this stuff does dry pretty well. It doesn't dry super, super like I said, it dries a little bit rubbery, but that's not a bad thing because it does end up, yeah, it's a little rubbery, but it certainly does dry strong, though. It's not like super wimpy. And so you don't have to worry that you're going to have something that doesn't glue or isn't strong enough or whatever, especially once you give it some time. Initially, you could squish something and you could destroy the whole thing. But the other one did better. Bloop. The other one was much, had much more finesse. Not too dang shabby. Squish it down. Looks relatively even. I can go in here and remove my extra glue. That. I'll be a son of a gun, not too shabby. Not too worried if that doesn't look exactly centered, that hole, because this is the back side anyway. Now, again, I don't know if that hole is that important. I might be putting too much importance on that hole. And one more time. Put a little bit of glue all the way around here. Sort of in a bead. Gives me a little bit of gap filling ability. Pop it right down there, like so. Line it up. This one isn't as important, I don't think, because again, it's not. It's structural probably, but it's not really doing anything else. There you go. Looks good. Looks flat. And I can come around and get some of these if I don't like some of the edging. But there's the basic crankcase. All done. And then what we'll do next is start building the cylinders, which are tedious, but they go right here and here and here and all the way around. And there's 9 of them because it's a 9-cylinder rotary engine. But there you go. There's the beginning of our Nieuport 24. I hope we're all learning something. See you next time.